Donation app fund. I got the answer. I can handle the hard question.
See, they say that Angel Snuff Nuff 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Nuff 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth. And I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride. Ride, let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Taliq Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for, a change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ibn Rod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
Why the fuck would I shit on my own bathroom floor? Why the fuck would I shit on my own bathroom floor? Why the fuck would I shit on my own bathroom floor? Why the fuck would I shit on my own bathroom floor? Actually, people, you really think that I'm shitting on my own bathroom floor? I'm just, that shit is crazy. Why the fuck would I shit on my own bathroom floor? Turds or whatever on my bathroom floor? No the hell, you seen turds or whatever on my bathroom floor? No the hell, you seen turds or whatever on my bathroom floor? No the hell, he didn't. No the hell, he didn't.
Michael!
even call me daddy, call me Joseph. Because his children was property for him to use and do what he pleased. Michael Jackson felt so good to tell his father, just like Satan told God, I'm out of here. I'm gone. Tell you what you can, tell you how to live. Sit your punk ass down somewhere. I'd rather be dead. Slavery is over for me. Slavery was over for Michael Jackson. Had to tell his crazy ass daddy, I'm out of here. His daddy threatened him, threatened to shoot him with a shotgun. What I'm gonna do to you? Y'all crazy as hell. I don't want you around. I'm glad y'all stay the hell away from me. But if you come here and you think you're gonna force your garbage on me, I will embrace the teachings of the Quran. Fight with those who fight with you. Better take that slave ass crap on somewhere. Is freedom just equality or nothing at all? For everybody. Your racist ass, hateful ass, jealous ass, you damn murderer, rapist, child molester. Take your happy ass on somewhere, sit down.
I'm not scared of you. All these niggas around here might be scared of you, but I'm not.
You take your ass home.
No, fuck you. You lucky I'm not a man, otherwise I kick your ass myself.
Shut up! Oh, y'all, y'all want some? Beat him down, beat you down. Who else wants some? Who else wants some of the D-ball? Well,
Crank it up!
Shut up, Crank. Come on, Crank.
Yes. I want that. Oh, I need that. Got to have that. It's
Snuff.
You know, for real. So, you know, like I said, all I can say is, you know, hey, each is to his own, like they say, but leave us alone over here at Operation Exodus, Mississippi, a.k.a. Reality Temple on Earth. You know, leave us alone.
Is there anyone out there who still isn't clear about what doing drugs does? Okay, last time. This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
I want to send a special shout out to the brothers who are DOR or Deacons of Reality Production. I must say, your work and the quality of your work is incredible. You are definitely very valuable piece of this machinery that we call the Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry.
Hey. Snuffnose. Angel Snuffnose. Angel Snuffnose. Angel Snuffnose.
You know, if you ever need anybody to talk to, I'm here for you the way you were here for me. Thanks, buddy. Yeah, of course, man. Let's talk.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for, a change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
State is now 8 of 11 for 73%. They've hit 7 of their last 8. Down goes Curry. Schroeder for 3. Denver the offensive.
Whoa!
I was just thinking to myself and just wondering about the mindset of these who were once called the American Negro. And we do harbor great talent. We harbor great intelligence, and we have great potential. But it seems as though we don't know how to use our talent. And one reason why we don't know how to use our talent is because we base our talent, we base our thinking upon somebody else. And so that hinders our own personal development, trying to copy somebody from 1930, trying to copy somebody from 1950, 1960, 1980, 5,000 years ago, 200,000 years ago, or whatever. So it hinders our own personal development in our time. Those times, like your parents grew up in similar circumstance, but their time was their time. And your time is your time, and you want to solve or use the same solution that your parents or your ancestors or the mindset or the beliefs that your ancestors, those prior to yourself, you want to use those things from your ancestors or your parents, of which in many cases did not help them, because had it benefit or help them, we would be in a much better position instead of actually going backwards. There has been no progress among the so-called Negro in America since the 1960s. And in just a few more years, within the next 20, 30 years, it will be 100 years after the Civil Rights Movement, and our generation, the children of the Civil Rights Movement, and the children of those who were the children of the Civil Rights Movement have not progressed, have not done and accomplished nothing, still living on the crumbs and the scraps from the little effort and accomplishments that was gained during the 1960s, early 1970s. That's a shame. We should really be ashamed of ourselves. We love basketball. We love football. We love to play video games. Some of us, we love war. We talk about war. We talk about battle. We talk about being soldiers and warriors. And when you look at all of these things, you have to have, or what would be good, you have to have the element of surprise. Right before, if you're watching the long version of this video, you will see basketball player, as they say, getting shook. The brother is going one way. All of a sudden he turns. And the guy or the brother that's defending him thinks he's going to go that way. And he doesn't. He gets shook. The element of surprise. The element of surprise. If we go to war, a soldier loves the element of surprise. That's a great advantage. Doing something your opponent or your enemy does not know you're going to do. So I play basketball. And I don't dribble that well. So those who play with me, they will say, guard him on his right side. Because they notice that's my strong side. And if the strategy is, if you guard me on my right side, I can't dribble to my left. So guard him on the right to defend him and shut him down. So, of course, my opponent who is defending or who is guarding me gonna take that advice and guard me on my right side because that's my strong side and they know they can shut me down. But as we go down the court, I switch over quick to my left, run my left just long enough, strong, to get away from the person that's guarding me, and I'm gone. The person that's guarding me is shook. They're shook. Doing something that nobody don't expect. Here we are in Pan-Africanism. Here we are in pro-blackness. Here we are in blackity black, Hebrew Israelite, all these religious spiritual teachings. All of this is the norm. All of it is expected. So your enemies and those who you are fighting with know your strategy. They know what you're going to do. They know how you think. They know what you're going to say. There is no element of surprise. In blackity black, there is no element of surprise in black conscious, pro-blackness, pan-Africanism, blackity black, Hebrew Israelite, comedic scholarship, and the list goes on and on. And you wonder why you can't progress because everybody knows your game strategy. Everybody knows how you think. Everybody knows what you're going to do, and you have been doing nothing. You're making no progress since the 1960s. I would also like to say this. About a month ago, there was a war declared on this platform. And we were underestimated. And so some of the heavy hitters got together and form what we call the demons of darkness. And it was said in their chat room, after this meeting, the Realities Temple on Earth, Angel Snubnub 7, he's not going to be able to recover from this. We bringing him down. But again, we make a mistake when we underestimate our opponent. We underestimate our enemy. And we don't consider the element of surprise. Now, they knew that Angel Snubnub 7 going to defend this ministry to the best of my ability. But they had no idea. And they got shook when out of nowhere come these brothers, which they already existed. We call them the Deacons of Reality, we call them the Deacons of Reality Productions, Soul Brother 85, Twin Pyramid, we already knew, but we didn't know. And it was a surprise to me. It was a surprise to everybody. They come out of nowhere and start blasting these bullets, these little short gems, these videos. The element of surprise. And then we use our enemy's own words and we bring receipts. So we make mockery of them. We laugh at them. And we bring receipts. And we bring logic. And they fall. And they fail quickly. Quickly, right? Let's get this party started right. Let's get this party started quickly, 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 right? These brothers come out of nowhere. The element of surprise. And that's what the Reality's Tip on Earth Internet Ministry is about. The element of surprise. Strategy. Doing something, saying something, changing your mindset. A new mindset. A new way of doing things. And it throws your opponents. They don't know what to do. What is he doing? I know the brother that was guarding me playing basketball. He was scratching his head. Guard my right. All of a sudden, I went to the left and left him in the dust. I'm not bragging myself, but it's going to take more than one person to guard me. At that time, I'm an old man now, but even when I was in my 30s, I was playing with young boys, teenagers. I leave them in the dust. I was fast. I was unorthodox. One of the best fighters, best boxers, the best baseball players are the ones who can box with their left, use their left. Box with your left. Hit with your left. Unorthodox. Doing something different. Because nobody is you. It's new. How do you defend? It's never been seen before. The Reality's Tip on Earth has never been seen before. It's brand new. It's unique. It's original. We are pro-blackness. Without being pro-black, we are pan-African without being pan-African. We are Christians without being Christians. They've never seen nothing like this before. And you can't comprehend because you won't let yourself think. You won't let your mind be flexible. You're stuck in the teachings. You're stuck in the information and the scholarship, but you're not, your brain is not developed. How do I use this information? Is it the appropriate information? And we tell you it's not the appropriate information. You do not use a screwdriver when you need a hammer. You can hammer with a screwdriver, but that's not the right tool. So I want to send a shout out. And again, shout out to the Deacons of Reality for being the shock of the hour, for being that surprise element. And they all look so stupid. They all was took by surprise. They all was shook. They all feel dumb. Continue this great work from our Deacons of Reality.
Buddy Joe.
Yes. I want that. Oh, I need that. Got to have that.
I mean, there's a lot of there's a lot of people that I know that on every different camps, Moors and the Wapians, Muslims, atheists, agnostic. Well, I mean, there's a lot of there's a lot of people that I know that on every different camps, Moors and the Wapians, Muslims, atheists, agnostic, what have you. Don't get me wrong. It's just when we're on YouTube and what have you stuff. So we get that they resonate that it seems like. You know, because of the personality that's being resonated, it seems like the most of them are like that.
Allow me to partologize myself. Suppositorily speaking, my incarceration has forced, you understand, the ventilation of, shall I say, my derriere. And upon my discharge, I will evacuate excuse me, ejaculate my mind to the prophylactic of the bowels of society.
You know what I'm saying?
Never lie, steal, cheat, or drink. You must lie.
A very vaginative proposition, my man. That is to say, prostitution pertaining to the cotec, you understand, of the argument. I myself have imminentized my liquidation, therefore, ergo, i.e., that is the instigation, which is excessive cleavage, shall we say. So, let me clarify. Or, excuse me, clitify. In other words, I'd probably teach.
Trump lights. Trump lights. Trump lights.
Yes. I want that. Oh, I need that. Guts to have that. It's
due to feces.
Yes, I like to talk about my experiences, you know, dealing with my dilemmas, with life, and the topic of this video, on that note, is going to be my journey.
Want to respond, but you didn't.
Okay.
But it's 3 hours or something here, and like I said, it's very easy.
So, brother 85, who are you telling to stop talking? You don't tell me what to do.
Oh, we really getting out of here.
I'm a grown ass.
I'm Dr. Crocker. Subscribe.
And, you stop talking.
And you.
I don't care about you, what you think about me not being not being ladylike. I don't care about that.
And so, I'm dealing with a person. Sister, no, if you don't like me like that, We still
look,
cool.
I don't insinuate anything. I never said I didn't like you. I never said that.
I said,
if you don't want me to come back on your platform, you can tell me that too. If you
I
don't
said,
want me to come back on your platform.
I use the word if you don't listen because you
only never said that I don't like you. I never said that. But if you don't want me to come back on your platform, tell me now, and I won't come back.
I said that. I said if. You see, y'all get so emotional, you don't even hear me. I said if the word if. I said if you have a problem with me, whatever. I mean, we still cool. I don't hate people. I don't hold grudges against people. Because I'm not dysfunctional. I have no mental illness. I don't trip like that. It's not that serious to me. If you don't like the list of the campaign, you just don't like it.
I'm so glad that 85 is being a fucking asshole right now. But keep talking, nigga. Keep talking.
Well, anyway, we out of here. And thank you for listening. I hate when things go like this. But yeah, just let it go, Deacon. It ain't that serious. Let it go. Don't
yeah, let him keep talking. Let him keep talking shit.
No, put
let him keep talking shit.
It's all right. We all right.
I already knew you motherfuckers didn't like me no way, bitch ass niggas.
You know, sister, like I said, I have no animosity or hatred towards Sister Karen. She can always come here and have her show too.
Okay. She ain't doing no damn channel.
You know, well, I mean,
I'm telling you, she ain't doing no channel.
Okay, but it don't bother me. I mean, I wish I had known this. See, it took this to bring out the realness.
I'm here for you the way you were here for me.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, of course, man. Let's talk.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
I'm not a killer, but neither are you. But if somebody attacked what you love, each one of you in here would become a killer instantaneously. Am I lying? Mother, let somebody look like they're attacking your child. Here's a woman who fought a bear because the bear snatched her baby. And she ran the bear down, screaming until the bear dropped her baby. Love casts out fear. We don't give a damn about no white man law when you attack what we love. And frankly, it ain't none of your business. What have you got to say about it? Did you teach Malcolm? Did you make Malcolm? Did you clean up Malcolm? Did you put Malcolm out before the world? Was Malcolm your traitor or was he ours? And if we dealt with him like a nation deals with a traitor, what the hell business is it of yours?